Hi, this is Teddy from Switzerland with another knife unboxing, and today we're looking at something very special. I have been following Koenig knives, or Koenig knives as you would pronounce it, if it was a German name, or if he was from Germany, since they started out with their Zenaida model, which was the one you didn't really need any kind of tools to kind of disassemble it. And then they had the Aries, which always was a bit too large for me, but I like the overall design. And then they had the Mini Goblin, and now they have finally released their Mini Aries. And I really followed the kind of secondary market to see if there was any Mini Aries available. And then I came across this version here, which is a modded one, and you will see what's the difference. And this is pretty much the kind of perfect Mini Aries I could imagine. Really, really happy that I could actually get this one. And I will tell you who actually did the mod, because I think this mod is an absolute must, especially for the Mini Aries. So let's unbox this here. Also, if you like the content, please subscribe to the channel and check me out on Instagram at 7ready_knife_reviews. So first time I'm opening here a Koenig knives box, and you can see it's a Mini Aries in 20 CV for the blade, smooth titanium, and it was made in August 17th of 2023. Other than that, nothing special here on the certificate of authenticity, but it is the Mini Aries, which is the first kind of batch of these. I think this is the first kind of run of the Mini Aries that has been released, and this is now mine, which I'm very excited about. It comes wrapped in this kind of Koenig knives microfiber cloth, and now let's take a look at it. So you first right off the bat see that it is the one with the bronzed hardware. There's also a kind of polished non-colored hardware and a blue hardware version available at the moment, and you see there is no flipper tab. And this was something I really, really wanted on this smaller knife, especially because the Aries flipper tab is actually quite broad and takes a lot of space up. And I think it looked a bit out of proportion in this smaller size knife. Really, really cool that I was able to get my hands on this flipperless Mini Aries. You can see 20 CV. And now let's deploy it for the first time. Really cool overall design. Very, very unique for sure. Here you can see the missing flipper tab, and the mod was actually done by Niche Designs. He will be linked in the description below as well. Very, very clean work, and I'm very happy that we could make a deal on this Mini Aries. So let's middle finger flick this for the first time, and that's a very nicely tuned detent for the middle finger flick. And the great benefit of having a flipperless Mini Aries is that you can do this very, very comfortably. So very comfortable foregrip here in this smaller kind of sharpening choil, forward finger choil area. And this makes this so much more versatile. You don't feel as cramped, even though this is actually quite a comfortable grip as well. Really, really happy. And I think just the overall lines of the knife look so much better without the flipper tag hanging off right there. It looks like a kind of super fast speedboat or a fast car. It's a very, very kind of gorgeous and fast looking design. And in this kind of version with these gorgeous bronze accents, the very unique kind of non-spinning pivot design, some very, very fine micro milling that I see actually for the first time underneath this 4K camera. So there is a tiny, tiny bit of very, very kind of micro milling on there. Gorgeous anodized backspacer. Small but functional pocket clip there with some springiness to it. And you can see if you look in there that it is actually badge 1, version 1 or something like that. Generation 1, badge 1, so G1, B1. In this kind of cutout, which I always really loved the design of the kind of this area right here. Also this milling that was left in the lock bar cutout there. Access to the frame lock. Of course, this runs on bearings, and wow, that's free falling, I would say. And that is pretty hard to achieve on a smaller knife like we have it here on the Mini Aries. Perfectly centered. rock solid lockup. Now let's take a look if we can kind of slow roll it. It works, but the hole is a bit in a slightly odd place to do this. Maybe we can middle or thumb flick it, that works also. But it certainly is a main middle finger flicker now without the flipper tab. Also blade finish here, very clean. Nice swedge right there. It's actually a hollow ground swedge, I think. Very toned down Koenig logo, two-tone finish on the blade right there. I love this kind of fluted opening hole that kind of disappears into the handle right there. Of course, there will probably be a kind of factory non-flipper versions like they did on the large versions, and there certainly will be different kind of handle millings. But when I saw this one become available on the secondary market, I really had to pick it up because I was waiting for a Mini Aries for a long time to experience the quality and craftsmanship of Koenig knives. And this was just kind of the perfect mix that came together, and the price was good as well. So really happy to have this one here in the collection. And there will be a full review of this one once I had time to kind of look it over and carry and use it for a bit. But I can tell you right now, it is going to be a very good review, and I highly would recommend you to check out if you're able to get a flipperless version, or maybe wait for the non-flipper version of the Mini Aries. Because I really think that they will do those for future versions. Of course, if you want to have some cool milling on the handle, it's also a good idea to wait. But just in terms of a functional version of this knife, I think this is pretty much unbeatable. And I love the pop of color with the bronze. I prefer it over the blue. And yeah, I'm super, super happy with this one. Let's take a look at some comparisons here with some very popular models that you might like if you were looking for a Mini Aries. We have my now pretty old, actually, Oz Roosevelt, or OZ Machine Company Roosevelt, which is very similar in the overall sizing. So these are actually quite good competitors. I would guess that the Roosevelt will cut a bit better here. This is also a very kind of early one. This is number 43 of the Roosevelt, the first that had the more kind of stabby blade. We came up with that together. Also, zirconium accents would look really cool on the Mini Aries, but those were not available yet. And then, of course, we have a very much a staple of the knife world, the Mini Sebenza 21 in the Insingo blade. And you can see it's slightly larger than the small Sebenza, and it's pretty much the same as an OZ Machine Company Roosevelt. Very, very snappy action here on the Roosevelt. This just feels quite a bit different. Also, I haven't shown you yet, this has some very nice internal milling. This actually feels quite lightweight for a full titanium knife, even at this size. So you can see great internal millings all around to make it nice and lightweight. And you certainly can feel that, and that makes this a great EDC carry. Together with just the gorgeous design, really a well done knife here by Koenig Knives. And stay tuned for the full review. Check out all the links in the description below. And thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.